cold in a truck.
I'm back. Rhodes Rants on Star Wars. If you like this video, like and subscribe. Join the Rhodes Squadron. Today, let's talk about something I addressed last week, which is the mainstream media. Disney is scared of them and won't fire Kathleen Kennedy or Ryan Johnson because they become social heroes. And now, the media is trying to cover Disney's ass on Galaxy's Edge, making bullshit propaganda news articles to try to cover their ass. This is from CNBC. Imagine that. Star Wars Galaxy's Edge is running out of lightsabers, kyber crystals, and droid parts, but there's still plenty of souvenirs to bring home from Batuu. Oh, wow. There's like 14 people there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 people. Carry the one. No, just 13 people. The shelves at Disney's new theme park land, Galaxy's Edge in California, aren't bare, but there are a few items you won't be able to get your hands on right away. The Black Spire outpost on planet Batuu is a mecca for Star Wars fans. Okay. All right, so that's just ridiculous. We're going to stop right there. A mecca for Star Wars fans. Fucking John Campia takes a little snapshot of him and, like, the two other people that Disney paid and his old lady and somebody else in the park. And he said, oh, yeah, there's plenty of people here. And there's, like, seven people behind him, like, down the street, something. It's ridiculous. He's holding up his blue soy milk of choice. It's kind of embarrassing, really. There's articles everywhere talking about how Galaxy's Edge is just barren of people everywhere. And I'll probably do a follow-up video on that. But I just wanted to show, look, the media is talking about, oh, everything is selling out. They're out of this and they're out of that. There are no wait times for anything. Disneyland is a barren wasteland. Well, but here, you know, CNBC just had the cover-up article. And now we've got an article from, by way of Fox News. Disneyland becomes a ghost town with Star Wars Galaxy's Edge opening. Here's why. Disney guests are claiming the theme park has become a ghost town after opening Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, and the rest of Disneyland feels, quote, empty. According to Fox News, guests have called Disneyland a ghost town. Quote, this comes as a bit of a surprise, not only because the summers are usually crowded. It's summertime. If you are not busy now, you are not going to fucking ever be busy. It's summertime. I remember summertime at Disney World. This is Disneyland, but still, you get the point. It was a fucking nightmare of 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 hour waits for rides. Similarly, guests have reported a decrease in wait times since Star Wars Galaxy's Edge opened. Disneyland said the opening of Galaxy's Edge has lowered wait times across Disneyland. Okay. The Millennium Falcon ride has only wait times of 30 to 60 minutes. They thought they were going to be 2 to 3 hours long. They say it's due to more wide open spaces and to several new attractions. Okay. And I had read another article where they had talked about the fact that Disneyland hadn't been this slow in decades. Literal decades. Think about that a minute. You open Star Wars Land and nobody's there. Nobody's come. That's great. Good job, Disney. Exactly nobody except John Campia has showed up to your park. And you're taking shitty pictures. Somewhere Christian Harloff's like, I could have took better pictures than that. Where's my ticket? Peace them out till next time.